is a Bugatti Veyron. If you don't know the Bugatti Veyron, then I don't know what you've been doing for the last 10 years of your life. That rewrote engineering for automobile. It just rewrote automobile engineering with just that particular car. Previously, no one thought 1,000 horsepower was possible. I mean, we knew no one really thought 1,000 horsepower road car was possible. And when VW bought Bugatti, the CEO of VW decided to make a statement with Bugatti. So he brought all the engineers up and told them that, hey, I want a car that's going to rewrite automotive engineering history. And he said, okay, 1,000 horsepower, W16 engine, 4 turbos, 8 liter, 10 radiators, a lot of crazy stuff. Actually, when they first made the engine for this car and the dyno tested it, it nearly bent down the whole factory. And actually, the engine in this car produces about, I think, between 4,000 and 5,000 horsepower, but only 1,001 horsepower goes to the wheel. The rest is just heat. That's outrageous. Out of 4,000 and 5,000 horsepower, only 1,001 horsepower goes to the wheels. The rest is heat. That's outrageous. And actually, they could have done this with maybe just a V8 engine, a lot of boost pressure, and just stronger internals. But they decided to know, we are not going to do that. We, the Germans, we don't do that. We go for perfection. And it went for the W16 engine. That's basically two VR8 engines put together to make that. And how many radiators does your car have? 1, 2? This has 10. 10 radiators. I doubt even... It has more radiators than some people's house. Definitely. That's a real estate on wheels. No wonder it's a deal on wheels. That's a really impressive car. I mean, this is my first time seeing one in the flesh, and for me, anytime I see such cars, I just get lost. I just, like, I don't know what to say. I think I should stop recording before I wet myself or disgrace myself. But it's just a lovely car. I mean, practicality, well, 2 seats. You have a boot. You don't buy such a car for practical senses reasons. You buy it to make a statement. I mean, yes, you buy it because you can go 400 plus kilometers when you want. If you find a road, you don't end up having a ticket or being arrested, you can do 400 kilometers plus. You can brag to your friends that, hey, I have 1,000 horsepower, which now it's still a niche, a high echelon niche. So yeah, you can see I have 1,001 horsepower. You can see to replace all my tires, it cost me about $20,000 or more. You can see that, well, I have a man from Bugatti who is always checking my car for me from wherever he is. Yeah, I mean, if you're a billionaire, there's definitely one to have in your garage so that you can just brag about it. Here, I have this car. But if you have it and you really love driving, please drive it. Cars like this are meant to be driven. Don't keep it in your garage, drive it. I know for some of you it's an investment, but please, come on, do us a favor, drive it. Let us see, let us have a feel of it, let us hear the engine roar, especially in the tunnels. Give us a blast, give us a rev. So that's the Bugatti Veyron. I don't know if they have a Chiron. If they do, I'll be stoked. Lamborghini Urus. Oh,